Hi there, welcome back. So in the last movie, we have created and set up the document for our tent size envelope design. So now in this movie, let's go ahead and create our actual standard tent size envelope design. So now I'm just gonna click on very first artboard here and click Ctrl 0 to bring it up front here so you can see it very clearly here. And now you know that what area is actually available for you to use. So you can just go ahead and you can just place something here, and here you can see you have also available this half an inch both side and here too. So now this is the area is actually available for you to use. You cannot mess with this particular area, because if you do, it's not gonna be best envelope design for the US Postal Service. So actually, you know, we're actually going to just place something here, but we'll actually tackle that later. So now what I'm gonna do here, basically I'm just go ahead and hit Ctrl 0 to bring it here. And now here actually you can see here is my logo, and actually I also bought here my this signature here, because we are actually going to paste signature there obviously. So let me just go ahead and grab it from here, and I'm going to place it here. There we go. Let me just go ahead and resize it by holding my shift and alt key, and there we go. And I'm going to bring it here. Well, you can see here, this is actually our safe zone area. So you can place your logo around here somewhere, because this is the place actually, you know, available for us to like, you know, work with. So yeah, this is the place I can, you know, place my logo here. If you want to place your actual business name, so you can just go ahead, you can place it here or you can place it here. It's really up to you. And okay, fine, let me just go ahead and I'm going to actually place it here. So first of all, I can see here this is our logo, and now I placed her logo. Now let me just go ahead and place here my website name, and then after I'm going to paste here that, you know, an interview based JavaScript course, that tagline. Yeah, that is gonna be awesome. So I'm going to show you two ways. Obviously this is the first way, and there's a second way. So this is the first way. So let's go ahead and let me just go ahead and grab this text tool here, and I just click here, and here I write jsinterview.com here. This is actually a site name. Let me just go ahead and make this small here, because of this actually web address. And you can see this Marriott Pro, I don't want that. I need Arial here. I can just go ahead and Arial, there we go. And I'm going to grab it here, some around here, and this is fine if I, you know, placing it here, but it's really, you know, we can actually make some changes here later, don't worry about it. So let me just go ahead and let me just press my control semicolon and see how it looks. So I just hide my guide. That's look fine here, so that's great. I can just bring it down here. Let me just change its colors to be something like this one, and let's see how it looks. So oh, again, I can see here, I don't want that much, right? So what I can do basically here, I can just go to here, select all unused colors, and then get rid of it. Here we go. Yes. And now I can just go ahead, select this one. Let's see how it looks. So that's look fine. Let me just hide my guide, control semicolon. That's look really nice, but I think black one will really look great. So let me just go ahead, turn it to black here. So great. And yeah, that's fine. Let me just go ahead and write here an interview based JavaScript course here. That is my tagline. So an interview based JavaScript course here. So this is actually my tagline here, and obviously I'm going to make it like a Sage script, what we actually did in, you know, my business card. So Sage script here, and this is really look nice here. See, yeah, looking great. I can just go ahead and let me just shrink it down to be something like 8 point, because 8 point is good enough. I can just bring it some around here, right? And I think you can see here, this is look nicer, but let me just bring it down here a little bit. Let me just make this a little bit big here. So there we go, that's just interview.com, and an interview based JavaScript course here. Let me just hide my guides here, see how it looks. So yeah, that's look fine, isn't it? Cool. So let me just go ahead and first of all, let me just turn into this color, very dark gray here. Yeah, there we go, perfect. This is what exactly I wanted here. Let me just go ahead and bring it a little bit here. Let me just hide my guides, see how it looks. Yeah, that's fine, cool. So that's look fine here. And now what I'm gonna do here basically, this is actually my website name, this is a tagline, this is a logo, but I also want to include my address here. So if my client wants to post me something, that can be actually, you know, it can write on this particular address. So I'm going to place my address and I'm going to here and I'm going to bring this particular fake address here, and that was my fake address. So I can just go ahead and I'm going to first of all, you know, create a text box here, and I'm going to paste that address here, and you can see here now it's actually turned to a search script, but I want here Arial, right? Arial regular here, and let me just grab this selection tool here, and I'm going to just, you know, paste in one line here. So this is gonna be in one line, so there we go. And here I'm going to just click here, and there we go, and this one is also going to be here. Great. So now let's give it some space here. So here we go, and you can see here this is big here, so let me make it small here. This is also, I'm going to make it small, and I'm going to also make this small image, right? There we go. And I'm going to just control A, place here, and I'm going to just make it small here, so around 9 but above 8 pixels. So let me just go ahead and check how it's actually on 8 particular pixel here. So let me just make it small, this bounding box here, and this is also make it small here, and I'm going to place it here. Let's see how it looks. So there we go, some around here, and let me just go a little bit up here and see how it looks. So you can see this is really look nice here, isn't it? Let me just go ahead and hide my particular this guide. So see, this is my address, and this looks fine. So yeah, actually this is actually no full black here, so let me just make this this color, right? So it's gonna look really nice here. See, yeah, cool. If you want to include some here address, so you can just go ahead and just write here address here, right? That's also gonna be fine here. Or you can simply, let me just go ahead and make this short here, because short should look really nice, right? So let me just make this color to be obviously full black here. So there we go, because now this is actually my address is not going to compete with this particular, you know, this ad headline, right? Great. So you can see that's gone. Let me just go ahead and just make it a little big here. There we go. So there's actually our address here, and perfect, cool. So now this is actually our envelope. So now let's go ahead and I'm going to of course place here premium here. So I'm going to create this rectangle here. Let me just control semicolon to bring my guide back, and this is gonna be, you know, first of all I'm going to just paste into my safe zone area, then we'll actually tackle it later here. There we go. So now what I can do basically here, I can just go ahead and resize it. So I can just go ahead, let me bring it a little bit up here. So you can see it's competing with this barcode here. Well, it really doesn't matter, because we have enough room to, you know, place there my barcode. So you can see here 0.2 inch is quite enough here. See, that's great. If I hide my guide here, see, ah, this look fine. Let me just bring it a little bit down here. Great. So let me just control minus minus to see how it looks. Yeah, that's fine, isn't it? Cool. So control 0, and I can simply just go ahead and add here premium edition quickly. So obviously premium edition here, and now I can just go ahead, grab it from there, and I'm going to paste it here. There we go. And like, you know that actually I'm going to place here character tracking of something like 800. So let me just go ahead, make this 800 here, and let me just make this white first of all. So swatches white, there we go. So now you can see here that's look pretty fine. Let me just bring my guide back here. Let me align it to center here, so this is gonna be in complete center. There we go. Premium edition, control semicolon to hide my guide, and see how it looks. A little bit down here, there we go, perfect. So you can see how it looks. So that's look really nice, isn't it? Cool. So here we go, this is actually that rectangle here. Great. Here's my address, here's my actually logo and my website name, and here is actually my tagline. Great. So now what I need to do, I need to include here my signature here. Signature is really really awesome, and this is not going to be real signature. This is kind of, you know, kind of like, you know, the signature which is not, you know, going to, you know, work on any your bank stuff or the credit card and all stuff. This is gonna be like, you know, general signature for public. Great. Actually autograph. Okay, fine, I'll leave it off. This is just a signature, you just add it, because it's really gonna make a lot difference here, right? So I'm going to place it somewhere around here. No, it's not good, right? let me just make it little bit small here. There we go. And I need to place it somewhere where actually it's going to look really nice. Well, I think it's really going to look nice here. See? Great, isn't it? That's looking really nice. Let me just bring my guide back. And you can see, we actually perfectly aligned this one. That's great. Well, you know, you can simply, if you have a small address here, you can just go ahead, grab this one and even include here. That is also really going to work. It's really fine, right? But now let me just place it here and then we'll actually know, we're going to just add it later. So now what I'm going to do here basically, what I'm going to do, I'm just going to this file here and I'm going to open here. And here we actually have this particular PNG file. This is actually, you know, stamp here. So I'm going to grab this from here. I'm going to bring it here. I'm going to resize it so it's need to fit here. It's really important to remember this one. See, it's fitting completely there. That is really great. So now it's fitting there. Now what I can do basically, I can go ahead and get rid of this guy. I don't need this, and because now it's fitting there, now there we go. There's actually our stamp. Great. So this is stamp. If you want to make it small here, this is actually no complete fitting stamp here. But if you want to make it small here, that is really gonna be great. So you can make this small here. It's really up to you. Let me just hit my control semicolon to bring my guide back, and you see I'm actually placing it to complete my safe zone area. Here we go. Down little bit. There we go. Perfect. So now let me just go ahead. Here we go. Yeah. So now it is my in safe zone. Great. So now let me just go ahead and control a semicolon to hide my guide back. And here, let me just go ahead and place, you know, a fake address here. So for that, I just get back to here. And actually, I have also got this fake address from internet. And I'm going to just bring it here. And I'm going to just place it here. So here, let's go ahead and get rid of this one. Let me just go ahead, paste it, this address here. Control A to select all. And you can see, actually, I have tracking here. So let's decrease this tracking to be 50 here, and that's great, isn't it cool? And now what I can do basically here is that this is actually a great address. Okay, so it's 9 pixel here. Now what I can do, I can just go ahead, let me just make some difference here, so sorry. And I think I just go ahead and bring it in one line, this part only. And now this one is actually fine, so I just go ahead and let me just place some line height. There we go. Perfect. There we go. Super. So this is the actual address here. So if you want to place it anywhere, you can place it because this place, you know, you saw here, this is the place you can actually place the address of your recipient here. You can just go ahead and obviously you can just go to here. And let me just bring it down a little bit here, because here we go. And I'm going to just add here 2 here, so it's going to post 2, or you can simply add here recipient. Obviously, I'm going to just make it 2 here only, right? So I'm not going to just place it here. Let me just go ahead and here, I'm going to just select this one. And here, I'm going to make it this 2, or simply 2 here. And if you want to place a recipient, it's really fine. It really doesn't matter, right? If you want to make it a little bit bigger, you can just go ahead and make this big. There you go. Perfect. There you go. Perfect. And let me just make it even a little bit more big. And I'm going to just, you know, bring it from here. And I'm going to place it a little bit up here. There we go. Perfect. And this one, you can see, this address is competing with these 2 here. So why not? Let's go ahead. And here, what I'm going to do, I'm going to just make this color, right? I have it already. So I can just go ahead, and there we go. So to Mark Johnson, A1831 LK St. Louis BLVD Lake St. Louis MO is simply Miss Macau 63367. Great. So this is the recipient address where actually this particular NLP is going to post here. And now let's go ahead and place here our barcode. So for that, actually I have available. So I go to file here, open, and I'm going to grab this one. So this is very simple UPSC state 4 barcode. I can just go ahead, grab it here, and I'm going to just bring it here. Let me just go ahead first of all and get rid of this guy. So there we go. So no. And I'm going to get rid of this too, right? And here what I'm going to do basically here, this is the barcode, we need to just place it here. So I can just go ahead, let me just resize it a little bit. And I'm going to just grab it here. And I'm going to place it some around here, right? So this is actually PNG here image, so that's why you can see here bounding box. So I just go ahead and let me just bring my guide back once again, and you can see here that I'm going to place it a little bit down here. There we go. Let me just place it just little bit away from the safe zone. Great. So there's actually our barcode here. Great. And if you want to decrease it, so let's say size, there you go. This is perfect, I guess. There you go. So this is going to be your UPSC barcode here, or state 4. So if you have another barcode, it's going to be really fine. But this is actually barcode here. So now you can see here, this is now the envelope for your postal service. This is really great. You can see here, this is actually our company logo, our company name, tagline, signature. Here, this is going to be posted to this guy, right? This is actually stamp. There's a barcode here. There's actually our address, and there's obviously there's actually no premeditation that tag here. That's great. So this is our envelope. You see it? I mean, this is really great, and this is actually U.S. Postal Service standard envelope. This is really great. So this is how you actually create your envelope. So now this is done. So now let's go ahead and actually I'm going to design the second front side, this one. And this is gonna be actually same, but here actually I'm going to just create that flip area. So if you open your envelope, so yeah, that part. So this is gonna be like, you know, this is upper one, left and right, right? So I'm just going to copy all of it because I'm going to obviously grab all of it here. Control C to copy, and I'm going to down here, and here let me just go ahead hit Control 0 to bring this front, and I'm going to delete first of all of it, right? I don't need that. And now Control Shift V to bring it here. You can see I placed in the place. That is really great. Cool. So let me just go ahead hit Control minus minus to, you know, zoom out here. And you can see here, I need that flip area, but there's no room. So what I can do basically, I can just get back to here, this artboard editing tool. And I'm going to just grab this artboard and I'm going to place it here. There we go. And you can see, there's actually our guide and all this stuff. That is really bad, I guess. Yeah. Let me just go ahead and hit Control Z here. And how to solve this issue? Well, because of actually, you know, we have just locked this guide here. I'm going to view here, and you can see here guide, locked guide. So I can just go ahead and unlock it. And now if I just go ahead and I'm going to grab this, you can see now the guide is coming with this one. So great, I can just go ahead, bring it here, and I'm going to bring it a little bit up by holding my shift key. So it's going to place it directly here. We go. Great. Now I can just go ahead and hit my spacebar. I can bring it here. And now I can just go to here once again, and I'm going to bring it some around here, I guess here. Great. So now what I can do basically here, I can simply just go to here once again, view, guide and lock guides. Great. So now I've just locked my guide here. I can just go to here and Control 0 to bring it front here. And now you can actually make some changes if you want. You can just go to here. You can just, you know, if you want, you can just grab this one and delete it. And you can just place this here, and you can just place this here. It's really up to you if you want to modify it. So actually I'm just going to keep it same. You can just go ahead and modify it to fit your needs. So I just go ahead, hit my Control minus minus to bring down. Here we go. And I need that, you know, flip area. For that, let me just go ahead first of all and Control semicolon to hide my guides here. Actually I don't need guide here, but yeah, this is fine if you know keeping this one. Great. So now I just go ahead, bring my rectangle here, and I'm going to create a simple rectangle here. This is going to be exactly, you know, that this is actually 9.5 inch wider. So 9.5 inch, obviously. So 9.5 inch wider. And now I need it 1 inch, you know, taller. So 1 inch taller here. There we go. And now I can just grab it from there to here. So you can see actually it's big. Yeah. So why that? Okay, fine. There's a 10 actually. It's 9.5 inch. I think I missed it, right? There we go. Perfect. So now I just go ahead, bring it here and place it here. There we go. There we go. This is, yeah, there we go. Perfect. So now let's go ahead and first of all, I'm going to just, you know, make this round corner here. And this is going to be one way. And then there's another way I will show you after, you know, showing this one. So first of all, what you can do basically, you can just go to shape here. And we'll see here, this is actually, you know, our particular shape. So this is actually corner here. So this is top left. This is bottom left. This is top right and bottom right, right? So you can see, actually, if I just, you know, link this one, you're going to, you know, just create a round corner for every size here. So you can see, You see, it's creating every side here. I don't want that. So I just go to once again back to here, like 0. And I'm just go ahead and unlink it. And now I just need this top left and top right. So I just go ahead and hit this one, 0.1, 0.2, 0.3, 0.4. And here also, so 0.1, 0.2, 0.3, 0.4. You see? Now it's done. So here you can see this is actually our flip side. So this is one way you can do that, but there's another way, and let me show you how to do that. So let me just go ahead and once again place here Control Z. So I'm gonna do all this stuff here. So there we go. So now I'm back to normal here, and you saw the one way. Let's see the another way. So for that, I can just get back to here. This is a free transform tool here, and click on this distort perspective, right? And if you want to learn all the shape creation tool available in Illustrator CC, then actually I have an entire course dedicated to shapes creation in Illustrator. In that particular course, you learn about all the shapes creation tool which is available in Illustrator, including this one, right? Great. So what I need here, I need perspective distort here. I click this one, and now what I can do basically here, let me just go ahead and bring it here, and I can click this one, and I can simply just go ahead and distort it. It's going to distort from both sides. So see how it's look. So basically I can just go ahead and click this one, and now I can see distorting both sides. See, it's really up to you how depth you want. So I can just go ahead, and actually you need some around 45 degree, but this is fine for me, right? Let's make this one, and great. And let me just go ahead and see, this is how you can actually, you know, use this free transform tool to just distort it very, very easily. This is really great, and this is what exactly I wanted to show you. You can see this looks really, really great, isn't it? I just loved it. Okay, fine, leave it off. Let's go ahead and create the left side one. So I can just go ahead and grab this one. So I can just go ahead create this one here, and I go to transform here, and what I need here is that 0.4 inch wider. And now what I need, actually I need something like a 4.125 inch taller. So it's same taller, this one. I can just go to here, and now you can see I can simply align it here. See, it's working great here. Cool, there you go, perfect. Yeah, and let me just bring it here, right? And here what I'm gonna do, I just once again get back to this free transform tool, distort, and I'm going to distort it like this one, right? Which will fit my need here. So there we go, perfect. And I can just go ahead and just grab it here and just place it here. There we go, perfect. So you can see there's actually a perfect distortion here. Great. I can just go ahead, hold on my Alt key, and go to copy it, and I'm going to bring it here. Go ahead, right click this one, arrange, and reflect here. It's going to reflect, you know, vertically. Copy. Or you can simply just go ahead, hit OK. If you just hit copy, so you're going to create another copy for that. So I don't need copy here. I just go ahead, hit OK. And I'm going to, you know, I just reflect it here. There we go. So now let me just push it down here. There we go. So now you can see here, we actually now have our this particular envelope here, and this looks really nice. What do you think? Isn't it cool? Well, if you want to include this particular backside here, you can just go ahead and include it. Actually, that really doesn't matter if you know, just include it here, because you know what happened, that you know, you don't want to, you know, print this one. You're just showing that's how it's gonna look. That's it. It's really, you know, isn't a big deal here. So you can just create like, you know, 1 inch or 2 inch actually, you know, taller. So you can just go ahead, transform it, and let's make it wider, 9.5 inch here, and taller is gonna be 2. Or let me just make it 2 inch here, and let me just go ahead. Okay, fine. There's a problem here. See, yeah, it's turned it. Okay, fine. This is actually linked here. That's why it's actually messing with my, you know, setting here. So obviously 9.5 inch. That's it. There we go. And now let me just make this white. So now it's gonna be white here. And now what I can do basically, I can just go ahead simply and just place it here, and you can just simply just grab this. So once again, this distorts to here, and you can just go ahead. And now what you can do basically, you can just first of all just click this one and grab this one, and just go ahead, and you know, you can make, you know, as much you want. It's really, really up to you here. See, that's fine. See, that's cool. But here's the one thing you see here, this is actually, you know, too much big here. So you can just go ahead, and it's really up to you, right? Make 1 inch, see how it's look. So that's fine. Let me just go up here a little bit, and there we go. I stick this one to this one, right? Great here, and there we go. So yeah, this is gonna be your back side of envelope, and this is gonna be your front side of envelope. So this is really great, and I just wanted to show you that how to actually create this one, because this is really important, you know, because of what happened if your client ask for I just want to see how it look. So this is how you can actually create it. This is so easy, and let me just make this little bit down here. There we go, perfect. So yeah, that's it. So this is how can you create this flip one. So now we have created this front side, this flip, and now let's go ahead and create our this back side of our envelope. So this is also gonna be very easy. So what I'm gonna do basically here, I'm just going to click here, and now let me just go ahead, hit Control 0 to bring it here, and Control Semicolon to bring my guide back here. And I'm going to, first of all, let's go ahead and place this rectangle here. So I'm just going to grab this one. So I just go ahead, select this one and this one, Control C to copy here, and I'm come back to here, Control Shift B to paste it here. There you go. And if you want to just keep it clean, you can just go ahead and keep it clean. It's really up to you, but I think that's really fine. Okay, fine, great. Here I can just go ahead, let me just grab these three here. I want those here, but instead of placing it here, I'm going to place it here. Let me show you. I'm just going to place it here, the JS interview, some around here. I'm going to here place it, a new interview just goes here, and this is gonna be our sign here. Signature is gonna be like just right here. Perfect. Sorry, I'm just going to grab all of it here and place it some around here. There we go. Perfect. And now what I need here, I need that flip here, because obviously I need that flip because this is actually outside. I'm going to place it now inside here. So for that, I can just grab this one, and this time I'm going to copy from here, and let's make it actually obviously 1 inch taller, so 1 inch taller and 9.5 inch wider. So there you go. And I'm going to just bring it here we go. So let me just bring it up here, and let me turn it to this color. There you go, perfect. But now what I'm doing basically, I'm just going to hide my guide here, and here let me just go ahead and I just go to this shape here, and I need this bottom left and bottom right. So 0.4 I need here also, 0.4, great, cool. But you can see here there's a no visual thing, you can see here. So what I can do basically, I can just grab this one, and I'm going to just go to effect here, go to stylize, and add some drop shadow here. So here we go, this one, and let me just go ahead, turn on this preview, so see how it's gonna look. So you can see here this is looking great here, cool. But here you can see it's actually coming outside this one. Let me just go ahead, and you can see I need in Y, but I don't need in X here. So X is gone. Obviously I'm gonna need Y here, but you can see this is actually too dark here. So let me just go ahead and make this little bit less here. See, now that's look fine here, great. If you want, you can just go ahead and maybe even smaller here. So cool. So now if I just go ahead, hit OK, and now if I just go ahead, click outside, you can see here. Now we can see there's actually that shadow here, and it's showing that you can just flip it to open it. Great. That was exactly I wanted. Great. So now that is fine, but actually I want to include my this logo here, and how do I do that? Well, that is really easy. What I can do basically here, I need to create a simple ellipse here, because you can see here this is not going to look great here. Let me just go ahead and grab this one and see how it actually looks. So I'm just going to grab this particular logo here, and I'm just going to hold my alt key, so you're going to create copy for me, and I'm going to just bring it here and see how it looks. So it's not looking really nice. So let me just, first of all, let's go to here, and here what you can do basically, go to layer here, and here I can just to simply I need to find out where is actually my logo here. So there's actually two logo here. There we go. This is the logo I want here. I'm just going to bring it up here. There we go. Somewhere around here. Cool. I can just go ahead, leave it off, and you can see this not look really good. See, it's not looking good. So how do you solve this issue? Well, you can simply just go ahead and grab this ellipse here. Create a simple ellipse here. This much big, I guess. And yeah, it's actually filled with some white color. That what exactly I need here. I'm just going to grab it from here, and I'm going to just bring it here. And let me just go ahead, and here I need this particular logo up, so I can just go select this one. I'm going to bring it here down. So now what I can do basically, I can just go ahead, grab this one, and I can just go to up here, and now you can see, there we go, perfect. Isn't it cool? I can just go ahead and make this small here to fit here. And now what I can do basically, I can just go ahead and let me just make little small here. See? Yeah, that's fine. That's look really nice to me. And now what I can do basically, I can just go ahead and let me just first of all align this one properly here. There we go. And now what I can do basically, let me just go ahead click this one and click this one both, and I just hit Control Z to group them together. And now you can see now it's actually grouped here, so I can select this one and I can just bring it anywhere I wish. Great, cool. Let me just hide it and Control semicolon to bring my guide here. And I'm going to align it in perfect center here. So I'm going to make it in complete center here. There we go. Center. Up. Let me make a little bit big. So this is going to be great if I just make this little big here. Let me just make this small here. I don't want that much big. And you can see there's actually a safe zone area. So cool. So now if I just go ahead and hide my guide. There we go. You can see here. Great. So now there's actually our logo and this is our backside of envelope. That is really, really cool. Well, if you want to include this address backside, well, you can do that, but you don't have to do that because you already included here. That's really great. And I just place here this website and tagline signature because this is really important, you know, stuff. So great. So now you saw that how to create this amazing envelope. For in this case a US Postal Service, but now you know that how to design an envelope. This is really great. So if you want to design your envelope for a specific country, and if that country need a different size of envelope, then you can just go ahead, Google it, find it out and design it, because now you know that how to create awesome, best standard 10 size envelope. Great. So I hope you like this video. If you have any doubt, then please go ahead and watch this movie again. And if you think I'm going faster here, pause it, play it. It's really up to you. And after watching this movie again and again and again, if you still have any doubt, let me know in the forum and I'll be there to help you. Thank you so much for joining this movie. I really loved it. So let's go ahead and see you in the next movie where I'm going to show you that how to design the big size of envelope, and that is going to be our final envelope design. Great. See you there.